Madison, and tonight Bradley and Purdue are playing for the championship trophy. They're playing for this. The winner tonight joining a long list of outstanding teams who have earned the title NIT champions. And we welcome you to Madison Square Garden in New York City for the 45th National Invitation Tournament, the championship game, a matchup of the Braves of Bradley, the Boilermakers of Purdue. Hi, everybody. Marv Albert along with Bucky Waters, and these two clubs have been here before. In fact, Bradley has won it three times. Purdue won it one time, and tonight, Buck, it is a matchup of the quickness of Bradley and the muscle and toughness of Purdue.
Yeah, Bradley is ultra quick, and they really do it to you on defense. They manage to spread you over 94 feet of the floor, and because of that, they have balance. Six different leading scorers, five different leading rebounders. Purdue has the muscle. They must make it a five-on-five half-court game. Cannot get in a track meet. If they do, Russell Cross at 6'10 is the dominating big man. He can get his 25 like he did Monday. And Edmondson, the nation's or the Big Ten's leading scorer, can go inside and post up. Half court, Purdue has a chance. Full court, no way.
All right, and in the semifinals here on Monday night, it was Bradley knocking off Oklahoma in convincing fashion, while the Boilermakers of Purdue squeaking by, just getting by Georgia, 61-60.
Purdue shot 70% in the second half to defeat Georgia, 61-60. It was Russell Cross, the 6'10 tower of power, who went 10 for 13 on moves like this for two of his 25 points. Mr. Outside, Keith Edmondson, the Big Ten's leading scorer, goes inside for two of his 25 points to help Purdue seven straight wins and nine of the last 10. Bradley's Braves blew Oklahoma away in the second half. Only Oscar Robertson and Larry Bird have scored more points in the Missouri Valley than this man, number 11, Mitchell Anderson. Great defense helped the ultra-quick Braves run a devastating fast break. As defensive ace David, the Sheriff Third Kill, shows the best option there is to end the break.
And Buck, there is a side note to tonight's matchup. As most people around the nation who follows college basketball are aware, Bradley coach Dick Versailles very upset about the snub by the NCAA, lashed out at the NCAA. You wonder what effect will that have in a game such as tonight? There are some feel that it has already affected the way Bradley has played. They've been on fire.
It's generated a lot of emotion. If you believe in the I don't get mad, I get even theory, you gotta like Bradley. But Purdue has been here three of the last 4 years, and they have most of the same players. The experience is here. It should be a heck of a matchup. You know, boxer slugger. You do a little boxing.
All right, we'll have all the action upcoming shortly, and we'll be back with a special feature right after these messages.
This bud's for that first day on the job.
This bud's for you, for all you do. The king of business coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This bud's for you.
Feeling, and every day it grows. You know there's so much more to you than anybody knows.
In the Army, we do more before 9 a.m. than most people do all day.
Hey, First Sergeant. Good morning.
'Cause we need you in the Army.
Introducing the Cutter. Black & Decker's most powerful string trimmer yet. The Cutter powers through grass, powers through weeds. And with the Cutter's command feed, just the touch of a button keeps the string at its most powerful cutting length. The Cutter, with command feed from Black & Decker, it can cut the time of trimming your yard.
And now, cut the cost too with a Cutter rebate.
Right now, you can rent any size gasoline-powered truck and rider's fleet for one low daily rate, plus a variable mileage charge. What a nice little truck. That's the daily rate. How about a little bigger? Same rate. You want one way out to here? still the same. When Ryder rents trucks at this price, we almost hate to let them go.
Ryder, $29.95 a day for the best truck money can rent.
Now, normally we reserve this segment for Bucky's scouting report. We're not going to let him off the hook. We'll get to that a bit later on. But Purdue and Bradley are here in the finals, vying for the championship. The other two teams in the Final Four, Oklahoma and Georgia, have gone home. For a while, the Purdue players and fans thought they would be making an early trip home. None of them will forget this year's NIT and their trip to Madison Square Garden.
And you'll know instantly if you're a winner.
I won $50.
Don't forget to record it.
Let Schick shave your taxes. $100,000 in prizes.
Over 12,000 winners.
Mommy, Daddy's here.
When the Ross's TV set was stolen, it was 5 years old. But Aetna didn't quibble. Aetna replaced it with a brand new model.
Aetna, I'm glad I met you.
When the Gilberts' house was destroyed by fire, Aetna settled in full within 3 days, so they were able to rebuild right away.
Aetna, I'm glad I met you.
If this is the kind of complete coverage you want, maybe it's time you met Aetna.
Aetna, I wish I'd met you.
And here are the officials tonight. The referee is Hank Nichols, working along with Mickey Crowley and Ed Cartato, all out of the ECAC. As we get set for the introduction of the starting lineups for this 45th NIT championship game, let's go to the public address voice of Madison Square Garden. Here's John Condon.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Madison Square Garden, the world's most famous arena. And welcome to the championship game of the National Invitation Tournament. Before starting, we would like you to meet the starters and coaches of both teams. First, the Boilermakers of Purdue University. At forward, 6'7", a senior from Lexington, Kentucky, number 23, Michael Scarce. Also at forward, 6'7", a sophomore from Fort Wayne, Indiana, number 45, Greg Eifert. At center, 6'10", a sophomore from Chicago, Illinois, number 40, Russell Cross. At guard, 6'1", a sophomore from Fort Wayne, Indiana, number 21, Ricky Hall. Also at guard, 6'5", a senior from San Antonio, Texas, number 11, Keith Edmondson. And the head coach of the Boilermakers, George Cady. And now the players of Bradley University. At forward, 6'8", a senior from Chicago, Illinois, number 11, Mitchell Anderson. Also at forward, 6'7", a senior from St. Louis, Missouri, number 35, David Thurkill. At center, 6'9", a senior from Chicago, Illinois, number 50, Donald Reese. At guard, 5'11", a junior from Chicago, Illinois, number 3, Willie Scott. Also at guard, 6'3", a junior from Joliet, Illinois, number 40, Barney Miles. And the head coach of Purdue, the head coach of Bradley, Dick Forsakes.
And quite a bit of support here for the Bradley Braves of Peoria, Illinois, and the Missouri Valley Conference, of course, but we would not completely eliminate the Bucky scouting report. Let's do it in quickie fashion, starting with the Braves of Bradley.
Well, when you look at their strength, again, you got to go with quickness and the flexibility, the fact that they can spread you all over the floor. Again, they're 6 different leading scorers, 5 different leading rebounders. From a weakness standpoint, they're really unpredictable. When they seem to be going well, they would have an unexplained bad loss. And, of course, they really don't have a defensive center. In the rout of Oklahoma the other night, they didn't have one reject, and yet they're pretty decent leapers. For Purdue, the strength is inside, and the fact that they have been able to control the tempo. They make everyone play them half court. Their weakness is quickness. They just don't have it, and as quick as Hall is, he's second tonight to Scott. And depth with scarce back condition, though he's starting, is suspect.
All right, it'll be Russell Cross, 6'10", sophomore, jumping against Donald Reese, 6'9", senior. Check that, third kill on the opening tip, going against Cross, and it's controlled by Purdue. They are in the dark uniform, black and gold, and Bradley in the white and the red. Ricky Hall chased by Willie Scott, Russell Cross. And this is Keith Edmondson coming off the 25-point performance against Georgia. And he is rejected by Thurkill. Thurkill, a sensational defensive player, can play both forward and guard. And Ricky Crowley with the call against Bradley.
Keith Edmondson had 25 Monday night against Georgia. If he gets 25 tonight with third kill on him, he is some offensive basketball player. They call third kill the sheriff, because when he has you, he locks you up.
Oh,
that's true. That's what the pub man said.
Donald Reese committed the foul. Michael Scarce.
Yes.
Scarce was a question mark because of that back injury. And so limited action here on Monday night against Georgia. Here's third kill. And we're tied at two.
That's more pressure by the Braves.
No problem with the pressure. Russell Cross providing Purdue with the 4-2 lead.
It was a great slam, but what it indicated is Purdue is going to take that ball to the basket. Normally, they're going to be concerned and try to hold it up over midcourt to get 5-on-5. That time, they went all the way to the iron.
Burkill off the turn. Oh, beautiful move. And Gene Cady of Purdue looking for either an offensive foul or a traveling violation. Scarce on the pull-up. And Scarce eluding Reese and changed his mind.
Scarce a little tentative with that back. He got about 14 minutes in the first half, scored 4 points, made no appearance at all in the second half Monday night.
Defense! 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 Eifert handling it. Defense! Defense! Ricky Hall. And Scarce.
Yes.
Purdue 6 and Bradley 4. Reese comes outside. Barney Mines, number 40. And this is Willie Scott, who was explosive the other night against Oklahoma. And an excellent shooting start for both teams. We're tied at 6. Scott batting it away.
Willie Scott is a blazer. 5'11", 150, they call him the Roadrunner. If you hear beep beep, you know who they're talking about.
2.5 minutes gone by in this first half. And we're tied at 6. That time the pass was forced. However, Purdue will maintain possession. Mitchell Anderson on the baseline, so Ed Cartano will hand it to Keith Edmondson.
Bradley zoning on the out of bounds.
There's Scarce, and he's called for the offensive foul. Mike Scarce, the senior from Lexington, Kentucky, called for the personal.
There we see an aerial view. Scarce had no room in the end, and a 6'7", 220-pound forward tried to make a crease, left a lump. Good call.
Braves of Bradley coming at 25 and 10. And third kill was sandwiched. Scarce and Cross combining on the foul. Bradley has made it to the championship game by beating Oklahoma, American University, Syracuse, and Tulane. They won the regular season title of the Missouri Valley Conference with a record of 13-3, beating out Tulsa, lost the conference playoff, and then were snubbed by the NCAA. That last foul picked up by Scarce, his second. Nice whip pass from Scott. Rebounded by Reese. And Reese forced the issue, trying to deliver to Anderson. Edmondson, his first field goal. Keith Edmondson will lead the Big Ten in scoring, averaging 21 a game. Anderson rejected. And it was Edmondson getting a piece of it. Very quick pace for the Boilermakers here at the start.
Surprisingly quick.
Pass intended for Eifert. And here come the Braves of Bradley, but the Boilermakers of Purdue able to get back.
Purdue going straight up man for man.
Reese, bad shot, Scarce off the rebound, directing Edmondson, who's being followed by third kill. Eifert. And the foul away from the ball, called by Hank Nichols. Russell Cross of Purdue picking up his first. And a timeout has been called with 4:10 gone by in this first half. We'll be back with more after these messages.
There's nothing we want to watch on TV tonight. But we're still going to watch something great.
With our RCA video disc player and video discs. Just flip a switch, and on our TV, we see Airplane or The Pink Panther, The Godfather or Grease, Muppets, Monsters, Mickey, and 100 more. And the player costs less than $500.
Put it this way, we're watching a great movie.
And you're watching us.
Buy your RCA video disc now at Cohen's, Sheridan Village, Pekin, and downtown Peoria.
Here's a solid deal on a solid Datsun truck. For a limited time only, Jim Smith Datsun has reduced the price on Peoria's most popular import trucks. This deluxe five-speed little hustler is just $66.24, $400 off the sticker price. And this King Cab diesel, with 15 inches of space behind the reclining seats, is just $79.74. Save $400. And with every Datsun truck you buy during this offer, you'll get this bedliner or this topper absolutely free. Save on Datsun trucks now at Jim Smith Datsun. Basketball, including Ralph Sampson, Walt Clyde Frazier, Tom Dolan, George Mikan, have won the Ned Irish Trophy. That is awarded to the most valuable player in the NIT. Now, the winner of this year's trophy will join that illustrious list. In addition, Anheuser-Busch Incorporated will donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of the Winner's Institution in his name in recognition of his outstanding performance during the tournament. And the MVP award to be announced following tonight's game.
Good tradition in both of these teams in this tournament. Bradley has won it three times. And of course, Purdue won it first in 1974. They were the first Big Ten team to win the NIT title.
This is Bradley's 14th appearance in the NIT. They were one of the original field of six back in 1938 when Bucky was just a child.
Well, you got that right.
Purdue leading by the score of 8-6. Bradley in possession. Here is Anderson. And rebounded by Scarce. Met by Scott. Here's Hall. Oh. And Cross was stripped by Thurkill.
Bradley a little tentative. They really haven't established the tempo they want. Hall that time penetrated in, and there was nobody back for Purdue. Bradley got the possession, but they really weren't looking to go with it. A bit tentative.
Thurkill gets it back out for Scott. Thurkill with an ocean, but met by Eifert. Offensive foul called on Donald Reese of Bradley.
Purdue's 2-3 zone that time, really cutting off the inside. And they were achieving defensively that time what they really need to do, play half court. Dick Versace, quite a character. He's got a few gray hairs there, like all of them. And he's managed to give out a few, too. He's quite a distributor.
5.5 minutes gone by in this first half. Nice play again by Thurkill. This is Willie Scott. Oh, and he had to adjust that shot over Russell Cross to tie it at 8.
Here comes the Bradley press, a 1-3-1 three-quarter court press. This is the second look. We've already seen a diamond and one full court. In order to set up your presses, you have to score. So it's which came first, the chicken or the egg? It's very difficult to come down full court unless you're putting the ball in the basket.
We're tied at 8. Lead pass for Edmondson. It is whistled away by Mickey Crowley. Foul before the shot attempt. And it's called on Thurkill. So that is his first.
Keith Edmondson at 6'5", likes to post up. Surprisingly, he takes Thurkill underneath where he's at his strongest.
And back drive, offensive foul called on Russell Cross. So that's his second. And Gene Cady, the Purdue coach, does not believe it.
Gene Cady was a fine athlete at Kansas State. He's in his second year here with the Boilermakers. Two NIT teams back-to-back.
Willie Scott. Nice play by Hall, but Mines keeps it alive. Thurkill, having difficulty locating shots, kicked it out of bounds.
So far, Mitchell, J.J. Anderson, number 11, the fine scorer from Bradley, has not been a factor.
He's had difficulty locating shots, as has third kill. In fact, he's popped a few from long range. Here's Edmondson. And Bradley trying to break. Willie Scott. Rebounded by Scarce. Purdue with a record of 18-13. They have won 9 of the last 10. At one point this season, they were struggling. Record of 9-12, and they had lost 6 in a row. Last touch by Purdue. Ricky Hall argues it. Gene Cady is told to return to his bench.
He took a firm warning from Mickey Crowley. Cady all the way up to midcourt, and Versace hasn't exactly been idling down there either.
Lines off the trap, and Scott from deep. Yes. It is Bradley 10 at Purdue 8. Willie Scott with 3 field goals, 6 points. He hit 5 of 6 from the field against Oklahoma here on Monday in the semifinals.
Third kill at 6-7 on the point of that press makes the pass over very difficult.
First time that Bradley has led. Scarce with the cross court, picked off by the Sheriff. Third kill off the steal. Scott, yes. And Bradley by 4, 12-8.
The Sheriff third kill made that play. He picked off that long diagonal pass and was moving. What a defensive player.
And Ricky Hall setting it up. Here is Edmondson, rejected. Scott with a 3-on-2. Here's Myers.
And it's Bradley fast break. A good timeout for Purdue.
A look at a previous most valuable player in the NIT, now a member of the Boston Celtics, Cedric Cornbread Maxwell. With the score, Bradley 14 at Purdue 8. Let's pause for these messages.
There is one $23,000 sedan today that has the nerve to put function first. The Mercedes-Benz 240D. Surgically precise steering. Tenacious road holding. Powerful fade-resistant disc brakes. The Mercedes-Benz 240D. Aiming to be as road efficient as it is fuel efficient. Aiming for efficiency in all its forms.
This bud's for everyone who's in the groove.
It's 5 minutes on the upswing of 5. Outside it's 87 degrees under sunny blue skies. Stay tuned for my man Flash.
I'm moving out of here, having myself an ice cold brew.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do. This bud is for you.
I know.
Bucky Waters back at Madison Square Garden in New York for this 45th NIT championship game. And Bradley on a run leading Purdue by the score of 14-8, sparked by Willie Scott, the junior out of Chicago, Illinois, who at one point hit for 8 consecutive points for Bradley.
At the half in the Oklahoma game, it was Bradley by 1. In the second half, they ran him all the way across park, and they finished the game on Lexington Avenue. When they get it going, you've got no chance, and I thought the timeout by Purdue, even though most coaches hate to use him this early, was a good one.
This is Ricky Hall looking to set it up. Purdue surprisingly started out looking to play Bradley's game, the lightning fast pace attempted by Purdue, and now it looks like they are back in their setup offense.
The defensive scheme for Bradley is on makes, full court pressure, back zone. Every time they miss, they'll come back, and that's up man.
Scarce with his third field goal, has six. And here's Bradley looking to race it down. Beautiful lead pass for third down.
Excellent camera angle that time. We could see that there was five black jerseys back, but they really weren't ready to play. And that's what we call a secondary break, a semi-fast break. Bradley got it down there, not with greater numbers, but they were more ready to play.
David Thirdkill, who was in foul difficulty against Oklahoma and was not able to unleash offensively here on Monday night, now with three field goals, 6 points. Russell Cross in a crowd. Dan Palombizio able to save it and nearly got away with a tricky maneuver. Here's Mines. Oh! Beautiful move by Barney Mines, the junior out of Joliet, Illinois.
Boy, the junior college transfer, his rep is a defensive player. He can also play run and leap. He went over the big guys.
Off the steal, third kill. Pulls it up. Out for Scott.
That's good discipline. They didn't have anything going that time. They held it up. Now they dig in.
Anderson not able to hit. And rebounded by Edmondson. Purdue trailing by eight. 18-10. 9.5 left in this first half. Palombizio, number 22. Here's Edmondson with the step. And he was fouled.
Against Georgia on Monday night, only three Purdue players scored at the half. And one of those was scarce. Here's Edmondson making the move inside at 6'5". If you put a smaller man on him, he posts up. If you put a bigger man on him, he takes you to the perimeter where he has excellent range.
Purdue went nearly 5 minutes without scoring. And here is Edmondson going to the line. Perry Cook, a 6'9" junior out of Indiana, has come out for the first time. Is authorized by Madison Square Garden Television solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or the use of pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the program without the express written consent of Madison Square Garden Television, is prohibited. This is Cook and Scott. Palombizio off the board, so a rare miss for Willie Scott. Palombizio nearly turned it over. Scarce in traffic, yes, and it counts in the foul by Thirdkill.
Purdue, a big hole down the middle, we can see from this angle. Excellent pass by Hall.
That's his second personal foul.
Little double clutch. I'll tell you what, Michael Scarce is putting on some kind of demonstration with a bad back. I have seen him moving around New York the last couple of days, and he is in pain. Purdue is hoping that he just doesn't get a shot in the back, because if he does, it probably will happen as it happened Monday, and he'll be out of the game. We're good.
What, are you trailing him around the city?
Well, he's pretty physical himself, but he just has a very tender lower back.
You have seen him moving around New York, huh?
Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. It's hard to lose him.
Mimes, yes. Bradley on fire. They now lead it 20-13.
Bradley now showing a half court, 1-3-1. Again, third kill at the top.
Cross from Palombizio and the foul. A nice pass from Palombizio to lead Cross.
A clinic on how to beat the half court trap. Palombizio right over the top. Takes it to Russell Cross. A good ball fake. Picked him right out of their Nikes. Wedges in for the 3-point play.
Russell Cross, one of the heroes. On Monday night, he scored with 4 seconds left to beat Georgia. And look out, some debris thrown to the court. And the fans, understandably, booing the move. And a timeout has been called with 8:29 left in this first half. Bradley by five, back with more on Primetime Sports after these messages.
Amen. images, reflections of reality.
Today, Zenith System 3 is close to bringing you the perfect image, with the sharpest picture in Zenith history, with four speakers for superb fidelity, with 112-channel total capability. Zenith, the quality goes in before the name goes on.
For the best deals on a new Zenith, visit Rick's TV, 315 Court Street in Pekin. Rick's is the largest Zenith dealer within 132 miles of Pekin.
They used to be called mobile homes, but a more accurate term would be manufactured homes. Homes built to look more pleasing and offering more value for your money per square foot. At Oaklawn Park and Sales, these maintenance-free homes are in a beautiful setting where the taxes are low and there are a large variety of sites for your choosing. And at Oaklawn, the owners live right in the park, ensuring you have continuing high standards and service whenever needed. So if you're shopping for a house, condo, or apartment, stop in first at Oaklawn Park and Sales, because you'll find Oaklawn delightfully different.
It has been a combination of Purdue turnovers and the hot shooting of Bradley that has provided Bradley with the 2015 lead.
Yeah, but when you look at those two stats, you wonder why it's only a five-point game. It just seems that everything is going Bradley's way. Purdue, typically a bigger, slower team, not very flashy, manages to hang in there. Their attack of the half-court trap the last time was beautiful. Right over the top with diagonals. Calabizio at 6'7", the freshman, wisely didn't put it on the floor. He diagonaled right back underneath. And when you don't put it on the floor, you help to negate Bradley's great speed in pursuit.
Bradley in possession. They are in the white uniform. This is third kill.
Mitchell Anderson yet to score. Give credit to Eifert, Calabizio. Two young Purdue forwards are really putting the muscle on it.
Lions feeding. Anderson going glass.
How about that, huh? He heard me. He had to work for that one, too. Calabizio was in his pace.
It is Bradley by seven, just under 8 minutes remaining in this first half. Ricky Hall walking it down. He and Keith Edmondson in the backcourt. Up front, cross, Calabizio, and Scarce. This is Scarce. Back out for Edmondson. And Hall, number 21.
I'm not sure why, but Bradley scored that time and elected not to press, but rather drop back zone. And their man-for-man has been so effective.
Hall had the open shot. Scarce off the board.
Yes.
He's had the good touch. Five field goals, 10 points. But Mike Scarce, who has had a terrific NIT.
He was all NIT last year. And those things in the crowd that you hear that sound like booze are not. His nickname is Scooby-Doo. Those are the Purdue fans edging him on.
Anderson. So he has hit two in a row, and Bradley leads by seven, 24-17.
Again, straight back zone, no pressure. Interesting. When they play straight zone, they take their quickness out of the game, and they allow Purdue to play the slower beat that they want to play.
Scarce met by Mines. Back out for Hall. They've been giving Hall the outside shot. Here's Scarce. The tip by Calabizio. So Purdue trailing by five, 24-19. And Calabizio, 6'8" freshman. That brought Dick Versailles off the bench. Oh, Anderson, and the ball.
I think Anderson must have heard me. He got mad. He's gone 3 for 3 the last time down the floor. This jumper's off the arm. Watch number 11. Over everybody. He almost put Scarce back in there. Scarce thought that ball was going to come out of the net and bite him. A very physical offensive rebound.
That is the third foul picked up by Mike Scarce. Substitution, Jim Bullock. 6'6" freshman coming on. Scarce, who leads with 10 points.
When you have a sore back and injury like Scarce has, the worst thing you can do is sit out because it tends to get cold. It'll be interesting to see whether he can get back in the action and pick it up where he left off. He really sparked Purdue so far.
3-point play for J.J. Anderson. He now has 7 points. Anthony Webster wearing number 33, 6'7" freshman. has come on for Bradley for the first time.
Purdue manages to hang in there the first half. In each of the last two games, they've shot 70% in the second half to pull it away.
Edmondson overshooting. And Webster deflected it out. Substitution, number 32, Kevin Stallings, 6'5", senior out of Collinsville, Illinois, coming on, replacing Ricky Hall.
The jumper from the corner, Edmondson, trying to get his points against that zone without third kill, a very questionable call.
And back live, Stallings, thrilling the jumper from 20 feet away from the left side. So Bradley by 6, 27-21, 5.5 remaining. In this first half, Bradley in possession. Third kill, watched by the combination of Calabizio and Stallings.
This is a big zone with Edmondson and Stallings out front, both 6'5".
Rebounded by Cross of Purdue. And a look from the end zone angle here at Madison Square Garden, with Purdue in the dark uniform in possession. This is Stallings. And Stallings makes it 2 out of 2.
All right, let's take a look at Purdue's defense. It's going to be a 2-3. Again, the big guards out front. No, it's a change. Here comes a 1-2-2. The first time they've shown it tonight.
And the foul on Stallings, pushing
Miles.
That's the first on Stallings. And both Bradley and Purdue have 16 fouls.
This 1-2-2 look with Jim Bullock, number 15, the freshman on top for Mike Scares. He's an exceptional athlete. He's a 100-meter hurdler, and he goes from the top of the key to the baseline, and he does it with power.
Purdue looking for a travel on Scott. Here's Webster with his first attempt. Anderson, a spectacular tip-in.
What a clinic on offensive rebounding. That ball was out of the gym, and he brought it back and put it in.
Mitchell Anderson, who as a high school senior in Chicago led the nation in scoring, averaging 43 points a game, has scored a bunch in a hurry. Palombizio shooting too hard and too far. And last touch by Purdue.
Only two guys in the Missouri Valley Conference have scored more than Anderson, and that's Larry Bird and Oscar Robertson. That's high cotton.
4 minutes left, first half here at Madison Square Garden. Greg Sanders of St. Bonaventure, who burned it up back in 1977, and another in a long line of most valuable players in the National Invitation Tournament. With the score here, Bradley 29 and Purdue 23, let's pause for these messages.
Michelob brings you the 7-day weekend, boy meets girl style. Meeting over a Michelob can show that special someone just how special you are. So don't just make a date for the weekend. Set the mood anytime with a smooth and mellow taste of Michelob.
I knew she couldn't refuse an invitation like this.
Put a little weekend in your week.
Yeah.
I bought my bathing suit, what there is of it, on the Riviera.
Very international.
Right down to my card.
So worthy, so welcome.
Last night, L.A.
Tonight, Broadway.
So worthy, so welcome. So worthy, so welcome. MasterCard International.
And back at Madison Square Garden in New York City, this is Marv Albert with Marky Waters. Invitation Tournament Championship game, and Bradley leading Purdue by the score 29-23. Mitchell Anderson has come alive late in this first half. He is now the high man with 9. Willie Scott has 8. Mike Scarce sitting on the Purdue bench with 3 personal fouls, leading the Boilermakers with 10 points. Russell Cross has been very quiet to this point.
With this Purdue lineup, without Ricky Hall, they are very vulnerable to the press. I expect Bradley to come down and get him. I don't think Stallings and Edmondson can handle this quickness full court.
Here is Pines. And he lost it. Jim Bullock lost the handle. And Bradley will throw it in. Third kill will take from the official Crowley. They are calling the foul on Bradley off the lineup. Anderson was called for using the right hand to push out. And now Bradley over the limit. So 1-1 upcoming for Purdue. Well, a group of journalists and officials of collegiate basketball under the auspices of Holiday Inn have selected what they feel are the representative all-star teams of each decade in the NIT. During our last two telecasts, you saw the all-star teams of the 40s and the 50s. And tonight at halftime, we'll show you the all-star team of the 60s. So that's coming up at halftime. Dan Palombesio looking to make a 2 out of 2 from the line. And Bradley now leads Purdue 29-25 with 3.5 left first half.
Palombesio was Mr. Basketball in Indiana, scored 31 a game, but Monday night he just wouldn't look at the basket.
Willie Scott. He has 10 points, and Bradley leads by 6, 31-25.
Here comes that pressure I was expecting. They're going to have a tough time with it. There just isn't any speed on the court for Purdue.
Katie is getting set to insert his 7-foot, 260-pound sophomore, Joe Gamper, over at the scorer's table. Russell Cross with his third field goal, and Purdue trails by 4.
Purdue is able to get almost anything they want against the half-court defense of Bradley so far.
Anderson, friendly rim. Will not count. Offensive interference. Call the basket nullified.
Good call by Hank Nichols. Dean Cady again out on the floor. Let's see. Was he in the cylinder? Anderson releases. It's off the iron. Couldn't really see from this angle. I thought from our vantage view here at courtside, it was a good call.
And Joe Gamper, wearing number 44, has come on to spell Russell Cross. Sits down with 6 points, 2 personal fouls. 2:15 remaining. In this first half, Purdue in possession, down by only 4. They've trailed by as many as 8. And last touch by Bradley. Edmondson, Stallings now at the guard, Bullock up front with Gamper. And Palombesio, a very methodical, slow club on the floor for the Boilermakers.
Not much offense out there, only Edmondson, really. Gamper at 7 foot 260, and that's conservative, folks.
And Gamper loses to Scott off the steal by Mimes. Brings to the front court.
The front court of Bullock and Palombesio and Gamper, they're just not good jumpers.
Anderson looking to sweep baseline and stepped out.
He tried to go down the baseline and there was Gamper, all 260 of them. All he got was a face full of 44. Watch him turn around now, bam, no room in the end.
Joe Gamper, a sophomore out of Cincinnati, Ohio, did not play here against Georgia on Monday night. But an opportune time for Gene Cady to rest Russell Cross. Just under a minute left, first half. Edmondson stripped. Nice recovery by Bullock. Gamper loses again, but this time a reach-in called on Mimes of Bradley.
Purdue effectively using that pass across the top of the zone. There's the play again. Gamper's going to come off with the rebound. He doesn't get up too high. He comes up with the loose ball. The quickness of Barnes-Mines, just amazing. But he got some skin on that one.
1-1 on the line, and the shooter is Joe Ganfer.
1-1 for Joe Ganfer, a 75% foul shooter, 12 for 16 on the season. 52 seconds remaining in this first half, and Gene Cady looking to use his bench in this first half. He has Ted Benson all set to come on. Benson, a 6'10 junior who did not play here on Monday night. Looks like Michael Scarce may be headed to the dressing room early, perhaps to have that back check. He shot very well in the first half, but picked up three personal fouls and was forced to leave. Here's Benson replacing Ganfer.
Very obviously, Gene Cady trying to get everybody he thinks he's going to need in the second half, trying to get him wet with the crowd. As we pointed out in their last two contests, Purdue has been on fire in the second half. They shot 70% both times to eke out victories. They eked out over Georgia. They blew out the Aggies of Texas A&M.
See the clock running down. It's time left. First half, third kill. Not able to move the baseline on Benson. 30 seconds to go. First half, Webster throws it away. And Scott grabbing it to prevent Hall taking possession in front court. So the turnover gives it to Purdue, down by only two with 24 seconds remaining in this first half.
That mop of white hair you saw in front of the Bradley bench was Dick Versace, and he is hot. He's hot at his own team.
Kevin Stallings back. Ricky Hall will sit down. And Stallings will throw in. And we're down to 15 seconds left of the half. At one point, you had the feeling that Bradley would be on the verge of a blowout. Purdue hanging in. 5 seconds left. Here's Edmondson. Nice pass to Bullock. We're tied at 31. Jim Bullock hitting just before the buzzer. So we have a dandy going here at the Garden. Halftime of this 45th NIT championship game. And Bradley and Purdue are tied at 31. A nice move by Edmondson, who changed his mind. He could have pumped from outside, but he decided to go down low.
Beautiful passing against the zone. Bullock very poised, goes up strong, may have hung on the rim. Purdue looked very good with the clock that time. They did not on Monday.
That's the end of the first half. The score, Purdue 31, Bradley 31. We'll be back with halftime after these messages.
Now that's what bread used to taste like.
Now that's what bread used to taste like.
What bread used to taste like is the sweeter, richer flavor of new Sunbeam Old Fashioned.
Now that's what bread used to taste like.
Sunbeam Old Fashioned is the brand new bread from Sunbeam that tastes homemade. Look for new Sunbeam Old Fashioned today.
Now that's what bread used to taste like.
Come see and test drive America's best-selling import, Toyota, at Peoria Toyota Volvo. Choose an 82 Toyota Corolla that proves an economy car doesn't have to look like one. Test drive the all-new Celica Supra, quality through and through, or the popular Cressida with European touring car luxury. And remember that whatever Toyota you choose, you're choosing economy, because Toyota really delivers good gas mileage. Buy now at Peoria Toyota Volvo, top of the hill on Knoxville in Peoria.
Lately, Bradley fans have probably noticed a new Dick Versace. At games and practices, I'm cool and calm. Part of the reason I feel is because of my waterbed from Waterbed Warehouse. I've never slept better, and I wake up refreshed and ready for another hard day. Stop by Waterbed Warehouse and let their professional sales staff explain all the benefits of flotation sleep. You'll feel great. I know I do. Now, if I can only get those refs sleeping on a waterbed.
Waterbed Warehouse, where the rest comes easy.
Petroleum comes from plants and animals, subjected to pressure and heat over millions of years. Amoco scientists are experimentally duplicating nature's work in just minutes. They have produced oil directly from plant life, wood chips, even grass clippings. It's a technology Amoco is exploring to provide energy for America in the year 2000 and beyond.
Back at Madison Square Garden in New York, Marv Albert along with Bucky Waters. We are at halftime of this 45th NIT championship game at Purdue, coming from behind, tied with Bradley at the half at 31. The high point men for Purdue, Mike Scarce with 10 points on 5 field goals, but in foul trouble he picked up 3 in the first half. And for Bradley, it is Willie Scott who had the hot hand early. He has 5 field goals for 10. Mitchell Anderson started slowly, but then came on. He has 4 field goals, a foul shot for 9. So Bradley and Purdue are tied at 31 at halftime. Now, halftime continues as we present the Holiday Inn NIT All-Star teams of the decades. Tonight, it's the NIT All-Star team of the 1960s. Despite numerous changes, there was still one aspect to the NIT that had not changed, even as the tournament entered its fourth decade. With New York City and Madison Square Garden as a backdrop, the NIT in the 1960s was still an excellent opportunity for teams and players to make the basketball world sit up and take notice. By the conclusion of the 1967 NIT, New Yorkers would not only take notice of a player from a small school in Illinois, but would have the chance to see the man who had dominated New York basketball in the years to come. NIT All-Stars, brought to you by Holiday Inns, the only hotel chain that gives you a no-excuses room guarantee.
You don't have to put up with hotel excuses like the maid, the TV man, or the plumber is gone for the day. Because Holiday Inn gives you this no-excuses guarantee. Everything in your room will be right, or we'll make it right. No excuses. Or that night, you stay free. You don't get this guarantee from any other hotel chain. Not one. So, let us take care of you. Holiday Inn gives you a guarantee, not excuses.
The spotlight of the 1967 NIT focused on a team from the University of Southern Illinois. Since the Salukis of Southern Illinois had just recently moved up from the small college ranks, fans could be forgiven for not knowing much about their star guard, Walt Frazier. But after Southern Illinois soundly trounced Marquette in the finals, there could be no excuses. Because of his outstanding NIT play, Frazier earned not only the MVP trophy, but also the respect of NBA scouts. The New York Knicks made him their number one pick that year, and the previously unnoticed guard from Southern Illinois was to form the cornerstone of a team that would bring New York 2 NBA titles in 5 years. The 1960 NIT final featured 2 All-Stars that were also to make an impression in the professional ranks. Providence, appearing in only its second NIT, was captained by its All-Star guard, Lenny Wilkins. Providence's opponent was Bradley, led by the powerful forward Chet Walker. With Wilkins executing Providence's game plan, the Friars found themselves ahead by 10 points with 10 minutes to go. But then Walker and Bradley took charge as they outscored Providence at 1.17-2. Walker leads Bradley to its second NIT title, but Wilkins' all-around play provided him the MVP honors. The ability of one player to control his team's destiny is demonstrated again in the 1962 NIT. Unseeded Dayton, led by its 6'10 center Bill Chmielewski, finds itself paired against a strong St. John's team in the final. Chmielewski had scored 83 points in 3 games to help Dayton reach the final. Dayton turns to Chmielewski again, and he responds with 24 points, and Dayton defeats St. John's 73-67, and Chmielewski gets to wear the MVP trophy. Dayton would also feature another All-Star of the 60s, 6'4" forward Donnie May. May had led Dayton to a second-place finish in the 1967 NCAAs, and now a year later, he had brought them to the NIT final against Kansas. His rebounding and 22 points giving Dayton a 61-48 victory.
And here's your room guarantee. And only Holiday Inn gives you this no-excuses guarantee. Everything in your room will be right, or we'll make it right. No excuses. Or that night you stay free. Enjoy your stay.
Thank you.
You don't get this guarantee from any other hotel chain. Not any one of them. And this guarantee comes from every one of us at Holiday Inn to you. Because we want to take care of you. We give you a guarantee, not excuses.
The NIT in the 1960s showed it was still the place for top teams and players to be noticed. And the 60s NIT All-Star team is filled with the type of players that can make fans sit up and notice. From the ball handling of Lenny Wilkins, the rebounding of Chet Walker, to the scoring of Dayton's Bill Chmielewski and Donny May, and finally, to the player who would use his NIT appearance to show New York its basketball future, Walt Frazier. NIT All-Stars was brought to you by Holiday Inns, the only hotel chain that gives you a no-excuses room guarantee. And to the 1980s, we are at halftime with Bradley and Purdue tied at 31. We'll be back with more halftime activities after these messages.
Thatch can choke a lawn. You can remove thatch by messing up your lawn with a power rake or messing up your back. Or you can use the self-propelled Snapper Hi-Vac with the economical Thatcherizer attachment. The result? A beautiful, revitalized lawn. And you come out in great shape, too. Snapper.
Get a free Thatcherizer with the purchase of a Snapper self-propelled or riding mower in Peoria from Garns Power Equipment and in Ottawa from Midwest Landscape.
The Bedroom Place presents a free inventory sale.
Many of our price tags have been marked down to half.
Yes.
Taking inventory is no fun.
No.
We didn't buy it to count. We bought it to sell.
Yes.
We're selling new waterbed merchandise and closeouts.
Why?
Why?
To make room around here. Come in, make us an offer during this free inventory sale. We'll make a deal because it just might be an offer we cannot refuse, I tell you.
Yes.
You could win $1,000 or more in Thompson Food Basket's Jackpot Day Contest. We'll have a drawing every week on television, and if your name is drawn and you've had your card punched that week, you win. It's as simple as that, nothing to buy. If the name drawn has not had their card punched that week, then $500 is added to next week's jackpot. Why, you could be winning thousands of dollars, and it costs you nothing to enter or play. Just register at your nearby Thompson Food Basket store. Pick up a set of the rules and get your jackpot card. Win thousands of dollars in Thompson Food Basket's Jackpot Day Weekly Contest. Register today.
Sino formal wear.
Style.
The look, the fit, the style you're looking for. Sino formal wear.
Style.
Watch Hawaii 5-0 Sunday through Thursday at 10:30 on 31.
A member of the Basketball Hall of Fame, the late Ned Irish, was instrumental in the growth of basketball in this country. The Ned Irish Trophy is awarded to the most valuable player in the National Invitation Tournament. This year's NIT has been dedicated to Ned Irish, and Madison Square Garden would now like to pay him this tribute.
Ned Irish had 76 years on Earth, during which time he made dreams come true. It is rare when one individual can have so profound an influence on the sports and entertainment scene. A few months back, I spent a delightful time visiting with Ned and his effervescent wife, Jackie, at the Irish's farm near Allentown, Pennsylvania. We strolled along their spacious grounds, enjoying the scenery, the foliage, and the flowers, but there was a lot of reminiscing, too. We talked about Ned's early days in sports. As a young sports writer, he dreamed of making college basketball a big-time sport, and he succeeded. In 1934, he promoted the first regular season college doubleheader at the Garden. In 1946, another dream came true. He pioneered the launching of the Knicks and the NBA. He was the Garden president for many successful years. Ned and Jackie Irish are their permanent residence in Venice, Florida. Recently, I visited with them, along with Ned's longtime friend, Garden Vice President Jimmy Wergeles, a friendship which began through Jimmy's father, promoter and manager Chick Wergeles, during his association with Ned Irish. The roar of the crowd became the roar of the sea, and the spotlight became the sunlight. The bands became the sand, but the memories and good fellowship were always present.
Thank you.
kept few clippings or mementos. There was really no need to. He had earned a treasured spot on the Hall of Fame. His guiding hand had helped bring pleasure to millions. His contribution is etched forevermore in the sports and entertainment world. Edward S. Ned Irish.
Back at Madison Square Garden, we'll have more halftime activities after these messages.
We know you believe in tomorrow, and we believe in that tomorrow too. Because at Southside Bank, we believe in you. And that's why we'll work the hardest to get you there.
The call of shrepivescence, the curiously refreshing sound that signals that a drink is about to explode with taste. Shrepivescence makes Schweppes mixers a far cry from anything you've ever used to dignify a drink. It's why we unhumbly call Schweppes the taste maker. Tonic water, bitter lemon, club soda, ginger ale.
The American harvest. The labor of farming ends, the challenge of feeding the world begins. Tabor Grain Company accepts that challenge. Through an international communications and transportation network, Tabor Grain carries America's abundance to processors throughout the world. Grain consumers are assured of a dependable supply of quality grain, and the American farmer is assured of a dependable supply of consumers. Tabor Grain Company, accepting the challenge.
New from Whirlpool, sensational bonus buys just when you need them most. At our store now, Whirlpool's regular capacity automatic washer and high-performance dryer. The washer has energy-saving water temp selector and water-saving load size selector, plus much more. The dryer has five drying cycles, including permanent press and three drying temps. We're waiting for you with our Whirlpool bonus buys right now. Come see us.
Come see Cohen's in Pekin, Sheridan Village, and the Place Center Showcase in downtown Peoria.
Halftime of the NIT Championship game, and Bradley and Purdue are tied at 31. Bradley led by backcourt man Willie Scott. He is 5-for-7 from the floor, 10 points in all, and also has 4 assists. He is now the all-time assist man, as he set a new Bradley school record with 222 assists this season with the 4 in the first half. Anderson came on late, 4 out of 9, total of 9 points. For the Boilermakers of Purdue, Mike Scarce with 10 points, hitting 5 of 6 from the floor. Russell Cross is 3 out of 5, and Keith Edmondson has been off thus far, 1 for 5 from the floor.
Significant team stats, rebounding. Purdue, 5 pad there, but they've also had 3 more turnovers. Shooting is excellent. Another key, Bradley attempted only 1 free throw.
And here's how these two clubs reached the championship game of the NIT. Bradley whipping by American, Syracuse, Tulane, and Monday down in the semis, convincing over Oklahoma. And Purdue with victories over Western Kentucky, Rutgers, Texas A&M, and the 1-point win here Monday night against the Bulldogs of Georgia. We'll have the start of the second half after these messages.
Bill Russell defined athletic artistry in the 1956 Olympics. And now he's been commissioned by Budweiser to create a painting to help raise funds for our Olympic team.
You get on the Budweiser Art Series and help our athletes train now for the gold in 84. And remember, the secret to fine art is ball control.
Call toll-free for more information on this art series from Budweiser, proud sponsor of the 1984 Olympic Games.
To minimize interference, satellite antennas are usually located in the middle of nowhere. After all, they are sending and receiving signals to and from satellites some 22,000 miles up in the sky. However, now there's a new kind of satellite antenna. It sends a more concentrated beam and cuts down interference as much as 90%. So this one can be located in the middle of anywhere.
G.
No, GTE.
Purdue and Bradley on the court preparing for the second half, and there is Tom Gola, a one-time NIT Most Valuable Player, led his Explorers of LaSalle to the 1952 NIT Championship. And one of the members of the All-Decade Team of the 50s, Tom Gola.
He shared that award with Norm Greckin, his teammate at LaSalle. And I grew up in that Philadelphia area, and he was my idol. The Gola goal. Some basketball player. Finished his career with the Knicks. Probably the consummate college player. He just did everything so well right from his freshman year on up. Ken Leffler coached those great LaSalle teams, and they were that great.
And we're getting set for the second half. Bradley and Purdue tied at 31. The question for Purdue is the back of Mike Scarce, and apparently he is all right. He was a doubtful for tonight because of a lower back injury suffered in practice before his NIT contest against Texas A&M. And he left the first half, left the bench in the final minutes to go back to the locker room for repairs. Apparently he's all right. He is playing with three personal fouls. He had the hot hand in the first half. Five field goals, 10 points, sitting 5 of 6 from the floor.
It'll be interesting to see if Bradley can again get that quick tempo that they established early when they looked like they were going to dominate. Purdue then was able, as they have been the latter part of this year, to get control of the tempo, make it a half-court game, and that's the way we finished.
It is Bradley in possession. They are in the white uniform, and they turn it over. Donald Reese lost it, so Purdue. And the black and gold, record of 18-13, coming in against the 25-10 Bradley Braves. This is Ricky Hall, number 11, Keith Edmondson. Michael Scarce up front, along with Russell Cross and Greg Eifert.
A new look for the Braves, full court man for man pressure.
Here's Scarce. Eifert blew an easy tip, and the foul call. It's against Purdue. There's a fellow by the name of Ronaldo Snipes who fought Scott Frank over the weekend in a controversial draw. Ronaldo, who is now living in the New York area, taking in the basketball action here at the Garden. That last foul committed by Russell Cross. We're tied at 31, and Bradley in possession. They led by as many as 8 in the first half. Spectacular move by Willie Scott, and it's Bradley by 2, 33-31.
What a game he's having. He was 5 for 7 the first half, 4 big assists to put him over 200 for the year. Boy, is he quick.
Here's Cross, rebound, third kill. Willie Scott, Hines.
Remember now, at the half in the Bradley game against Oklahoma, it was a one-point game, and they were awesome in the second half. Just blew them right out of the building.
Purdue now to the offense. Here's Hall. Scarce back out for Eifert. 2 minutes gone by in this first half. And the foul called. Basket will not count.
All white on the hold. You want a timeout?
Scott showing afterburner speed. Blows by half the defense. Edmondson makes a swipe, but to no avail. The afterburners were lit. The Bradley bench, associate coach Tony Barone. Dick Forsace gives him much of the credit for the organization of the Braves. He was an assistant of mine at Duke and a fine player at Duke.
Here's Cross. Russell Cross for his fourth field goal has 8. And we're tied at 33.
Nice lead. Anderson on the reverse. Mitchell Anderson with 11 points. And it's Bradley by 2, 35-33.
And he put that one in under duress because Scarce was very close to getting his fourth foul. He was hanging right on that ball.
Edmondson, who has had his problems, way off as he was pressured by Thurkill. Keith Edmondson is now 1-for-6 from the floor, coming off the 25-point game here Monday against Georgia. Here's Reese. Yes. Donna Reese hitting his first field goal, and it's Bradley by 4, 37-33, an angry Purdue coach Gene Katie looking to go to his bench.
I said at the top of the show that Thurkill would probably hold Edmondson well below that 25. He's some kind of defensive player.
And Hall foul. Willie Scott picks up his first. Dan Palombisio, number 22, making his way back into the lineup.
Again, the afterburner speed of the quick guards. That time Hall blew by Scott. Turn around his fair play. Dick Versace, the man with the white hair. 64 Wisconsin grad.
Scarce on the follow, but stolen by Scott. He has a three-on-one. Oh, beautifully executed. 45 from Willie Scott, and Bradley by 6, 39-33.
The exact same pattern as the first half, and it was right about in here. Gene Katie called timeout and said, folks, we're going to play half court. Let's see if history repeats.
Allowed to penetrate along the baseline, and it's Bradley by 4, 39-35.
The concentration of the Bradley defense obviously on Cross and Edmondson, and Scarce is making the most of it.
Reese tried to get it down low, and a whistle away from the ball. A foul on Purdue. Palombisio called for a hold. Timeout has been called. 15 and a half remaining. Second half. The score, Bradley 39 and Purdue 35. Back with more basketball on Prime Time Sports after these messages.
Adidas has a feeling for winning, and you can get that special feeling at Browns. Check out Browns' selection of top-quality Adidas sports footwear. Browns has Adidas for basketball, tennis, running, and racquetball. A wide selection of Adidas shoes are available at Browns. So if you want the Adidas feeling for winning,
come to Browns! Browns Sporting Goods for the games you play!
There are certain times in everyone's life where we just need the use of additional funds. Perhaps you'd like to add extra rooms to your house, replace an aging heating or cooling system. Maybe it's just to pay off some unexpected debts due to illness or what have you. The folks at the Better Banks, Dunlap, Wyoming, Glassford, and Bartonville, understand and are ready to make you a home equity loan at very attractive rates. If you're a homeowner in need of extra cash, come into one of the Better Banks near you. We want to be your bank.
Last season's NIT All-Star team enjoyed an exciting tour of Latin America and Europe. The NIT stars with the opportunity to play against the Russian national team, the Dominican Republic national team, and the Colombian team. Now this season, the NIT All-Star team will be touring again with games already scheduled for Italy, Germany, Switzerland, and France. The NIT's European tour, one of the outstanding features of the National Invitation Tournament, and certainly part of the lure in being involved in this tournament. I know, Bucky, that you have been one trying to write into your contract as a broadcaster for the NIT tournament that you should be part of this tour. To this point, they have emphatically rejected the thought.
I think they're afraid of an international incident.
Bradley in possession. Scott had it knocked away. And let's see, the alternate possession is to Purdue. Hey! as Fred Shouts, one-time coach at West Virginia.
And at Purdue, he's now the athletic director at West Virginia.
Preceding R.C. Bucky Waters in Mountaineer territory.
He was a tough act to follow, so was George King, who was sandwiched in between us.
Calabasio back out for Scarce. Russell Cross under pressure. It's a two-on-one. Anderson with Scott. Purdue got back very well. And Anderson lost it out of bounds.
One of the few times Bradley was not in control in that break. Mitchell, J.J. Anderson was very much out of control. Couldn't get the ball back in the middle to Scott.
Both clubs shooting very well in the first half. Purdue 52%, Bradley 57%, and both clubs off the slow starts here in this second half. It's Bradley by four. Here is Edmondson. Yes. And they would like to see Edmondson get unleashed now. He is only two out of seven from the floor. Last touch by Purdue.
I love that name, Sheriff Third Kill. Now, he sounds like he can play defense. It's an Indian name. And again, I have to repeat the hype from their publicity department. They call him Sheriff because when he guards you, he locks you up. And he's put a few under the jail this year. He plays defense with his body like he's got a spare. He really puts it on there.
Here's Third Kill offensively. Gets the ball. David Third Kill, 6'7", senior from St. Louis, Missouri, hitting on his fourth field goal, has 8 points. And it's Bradley by four, 41-37.
Bradley again backing off now, man for man without the full pressure. They are taking some chances in the passing game.
Calabasio, Russell Cross, and Cross was fouled.
Reese hasn't had much of a chance, but then Russell Cross puts a lot of pressure on you. He had three in the first half, and then that straight man for man producer, they really do some nice things to isolate him, and they find him.
Donald Reese picking up his fourth personal foul. A 6'9" senior center looking over to the bench. No substitution as of yet. Russell Cross. He's been off at the line. He's now 0-for-2. Cross is a 62% free throw shooter. There is Kerry Cook, 6'9" junior, replacing Donald Reese. Russell Cross, sophomore from Chicago, hitting on his first foul shot. He now has 9 points, and it's Bradley by three.
Cross was the rookie of the year in the Big Ten last year, his freshman year. Had a very ordinary sophomore year until right at the end.
Bradley with the ball, 13 minutes remaining in the ball game. Look out, Cook goes down over Hall, and Purdue will take possession.
Hall didn't think he could get to that ball, so he put up a screen, and Kerry Cook at 6'9", 210, labeled him pretty good. A smart play by Hall, but he's going to feel it tomorrow.
Purdue coach Gene Cady asking the official, Hank Nichols, why no foul? That's Big Ten basketball.
Wasn't any harm to anybody but Hall.
Scarce over Anderson.
All NIT last year, he just needs to get hot in New York.
Mike Scarce, 7 field goals, 14 points, and the Bradley lead is cut to 1, 41-40. Here is Scott. And off the rebound, a foul against, let's see, it is against Purdue. No indication as of yet. Now Scarce is hit with the call. That is his fourth. Timeout has been called with the score. Bradley 41 and Purdue 40. As you look at a former NIT most valuable player, Ralph Sampson of the Cavaliers of Virginia. Let's pause for these messages.
In
In today's Army, when artillery goes to the field, so does high technology.
Be all that you can be. Keep on reaching. Keep on growing.
Computers, laser-guided missile systems, and teamwork honed to a split-second response. And the Army gives you this kind of training with just a 2-year enlistment.
'Cause we need you.
Come on, one more.
No.
The championship of the entire civilized world.
I'll pass.
And a Michelob Light.
I'll serve.
Would good friends really go at it this hard just for a beer? Well, consider it's Michelob Light, and that means a rich, smooth taste you can compare to any beer you like.
I thought you were tired.
Nope, just thirsty.
Michelob Light. Compare the taste.
Basketball at Madison Square Garden, the 45th National Invitation Tournament Championship game. Bradley has been to the NIT on 14 occasions. They have won the title 3 times. Purdue has won it once. Bradley leads Purdue by the score of 41-40. And those turnovers have evened up. Purdue had the early lead in that department in the first half. Bradley led by as many as 8 points in the first half. We were tied at halftime at 31. It is Bradley in possession. Third kill. Yes.
He's going to make a fine guard in the pros. He's playing forward now, but again, it's his athletic ability. Extraordinary. Reminds me of Cy Hugo Green with the big step.
David third kill with 10 points. And it's Bradley by 3, 11:45, remaining of the game. Cross in heavy traffic was bumped.
Again, Purdue finding Russell Cross. Monday night, when it really counted, they were able to get that ball down low, and in fact, he hit the winning basket. Dick Versace, a man who says, to know me is to love me, and that's how he introduced himself to the press conference when being announced as the Bradley coach.
Edmondson heading for Purdue. And Bradley now leads by 1, 43-42. That last foul committed by Kerry Cook, his second. Cook coming on to spell Donald Reese, who left after picking up his fourth personal. Here's Anderson. Rebounded by Hall of Purdue. And the Boilermakers have a chance to go in front for the first time since very early.
Mismatch underneath, Cross and Cook. That favors Purdue. And if they stay true to form, they will find him.
Traveling violation on Edmondson. And again, he had his difficulty against Thurkill. So Bradley takes over. A backcourt of Willie Scott, Barney Mines, Kerry Cook. Up front with David Thurkill and Mitchell Anderson. Here's Mines. And rebounded by Scarce, who's playing with 4.
Bradley increasing the pressure. Still not going down full court, which surprises me, but much more intense half court.
Cross, foul, Scott came over, trying to help out, and picked up his second.
They've got to help Kerry Cook in there. The 6'9 junior cannot handle Russell Cross. Watch Scott, number 3. Watch how far he comes to try to help. The weak side defense tries to slip up on the blind side, gets some skin.
Now Purdue contending that it should have been a foul called in the act, but the official said no. Bradley now with 5 team fouls. Purdue has only 3. 10:20 left of the game, and Bradley leads by 1.
Bradley now zone on the out of bounds. They'll try to find Edmondson. Or that man who is really hot. Michael Scarce. What a tournament he's had.
This is Scarce over Anderson. Rebounded by Thurkill and a foul against Purdue. Colombizio is called for his second.
Watch David Thurfield, number 35, go up and pull this rebound down. Palombizio's all over him, a one-hand snatch. 6'7", 195 guard, the senior from St. Louis, a junior college transfer from College of Southern Idaho. He's a player.
Bradley back in possession. They lead by one. Thurfield moving left. Yes, and the foul.
Thurfield now very anxious. He wants that ball. He's on a roll. He really forced that play. I really thought that Purdue had good position. I thought it was a charge.
Russell Cross picking up the foul, his fourth. So both centers, Reese and Cross, with four fouls. Reese sitting down, replaced by Kerry Cook, creating all kinds of difficulties for Bradley with Cross matching with Cook. And now Cross will depart after picking up number four. Russell will sit down with nine. David Thurfield, who is now 6 for 6 from the floor, 13 points in all. And by virtue of the three-point play, Bradley leads it 46 to 42.
The Bradley Braves smelling blood now, coming down with full pressure.
Thurfield nearly forced Edmondson into a travel once again. This is Stallings, who just checked back in. Scarce, number 23. And a foul down low with Joe Camper, who replaced Cross, held by Kerry Cook. That's number three on Cook.
Kerry Cook was so glad to see Russell Cross go out of there. He was all set to play all-tournament defense, got a little hyper. Camper's not one he's got to really lean on. They're not even going to look for him.
Camper goes 7 feet, 260 pounds, hit a couple of foul shots in the first half when he came on late.
He didn't play at all as a freshman. Bad knee. This is actually his first year of college competition.
All right, off the Edmondson turnover. Bradley in possession. Willie Scott on the back dribble, setting it up on Stallings. This is Bynes with it. Cook setting up high. Stallings goes down. Here's Anderson in traffic. A bad shot, but he got a break. Not a smart play.
Proving he can jump. Joe Gamper up. It's no question it's a goaltending call. The ball was on the way down. A big guy can jump, but it was ill-advised.
Anderson receives credit for the field goal. We'll be back with more basketball on Prime Time Sports after these messages.
Farming is a risky business.
Careful.
You have to carefully consider every move you make.
Easy.
There are dangers in expanding your operation. Risks in marketing your crop more aggressively.
Watch it.
A slip could mean disaster. So isn't it comforting to know you have all-risk crop insurance with you every step of the way?
Petroleum, fertilizer, herbicides, new equipment. When corn pays the bills, plant DeKalb XL55A. You can depend on consistent high yields, regardless of growing conditions. Put more corn in your bins, more money in your pocket. Plant DeKalb XL55A.
Telecasts have been selected by Madison Square Garden Television with the approval of the MIBA, and I must say, in Bucky's case, it was a very close vote.
I heard the committee, the vote was 5-4 and a tie.
Yes.
On you. Yeah, you fooled them again. This is my sixth one. You got to remember, I'm the senior member of the crew.
And we'll be making the NIT tour throughout the world.
I got to work on the weights before I go on that tour.
In the second half, Bradley 62%, so they have maintained their pace. And Purdue at 45%. It is Bradley by 6, 48 to 42. 8:45 remaining in the game. Stallings under pressure from Scott. This is Bullock, who just returned for Scarce. And here is Palombizio. And they'll start it all over again. Last touch by Palombicio.
Without Ricky Hall in the game, Purdue is very vulnerable to pressure, especially at that point guard spot. Willie Scott is awfully quick. Kevin Stallings is 6'5 and a pretty good point guard, but the quickness differential is really great.
The Bradley Braves of Peoria, Illinois, and the Missouri Valley Conference. Willie Scott, yes. Willie Scott, 7 field goals, 14 points. And Bradley, the club that felt snubbed by the NCAA, now leading Purdue by 8 in this NIT championship game.
Bradley, 25-10 on the year. That's a lot of games. That's 35. Of course, they played in Hawaii, so 3 didn't count. A good timeout by Purdue. It's getting away from them.
7:50 left of the game. The score, Bradley 50 and Purdue 42. Let's pause for these messages.
Angelo's been working overtime on his flips. He needs the deodorant that works overtime.
Senator, Joe's been working overtime to get his story. He needs the deodorant that works overtime.
Only Old Spice Stick deodorant gives you both 24-hour protection from odor, plus that famous Old Spice scent.
Pluck has been working overtime, learning the new plays.
Sure glad my Old Spice Stick works overtime, too.
Old Spice Stick, the deodorant that works overtime.
Bid $100,000 for this Mercedes-Benz today, and you'll bid too low. Offer the owner of this Mercedes $300,000, and he'll just smile. $50,000 for this Mercedes? Not enough. Classic engineering breeds classic resale performance. When it comes to retaining value, the cars of Mercedes-Benz have made history, and history does have a way of repeating itself.
Boilermakers of Purdue, this make or break portion of the game, 7:48 left, and they're down by 8.
Purdue went back with Cross and Scarce, both with 4 fouls. They're trying to make their move now. I think it's a good move to go and try to get that lead back, because if they're forced to come after Bradley, the quickness factor will be very difficult. If Bradley spreads the floor, which they can do with a lead, then your big guys are of no value anyway. Play them now, try to get the control of the game back.
Kerry Cook committed the foul as 4th. Bradley over the limit. And Russell Cross, who is 1 out of 3 from the line, shooting 1 and 1. Sophomore from Chicago. Breaking Purdue within 7. 50-43. Purdue has won 9 of its last 10. They are 18-13. They finished 5th in the Big Ten, record of 11-7. They have really turned it around after the struggle earlier in the season. At one point, they had a record of 9-12. They now trail by 6, 7.5 left in the game, and Bradley looking to talk it over. So a timeout has been called. And Dick Versailles looking to chat with his ball club. We'll be back with more basketball on Primetime Sports after these messages.
Nice car, huh? Know what it is? It's the new Buick Skyhawk with front-wheel drive. Check the sticker price. How's that for a pleasant surprise? Imagine buying a Buick with a base sticker price under $7,300 and a $750 rebate, too. The Skyhawk is made here, not in Japan. Go ahead. Take a test drive.
Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick?
Capture the Skyhawk at Heritage Buick in Peoria, Village Buick in Morton, or Shearer Buick in North Pekin.
You know, there are still a few people around who think the waterbeds won't cut it. Well, Waterbed Creations, we can cut it. This is just a little demonstration to show that even major accidents can be no problem with a properly installed safety liner. The water is retained within the frame, so there can be no chance of damage to your carpet or home. So for answers to all your questions on waterbeds, stop by a Waterbed Creations near you, where the rest is better and we're better than the rest.
the colorful coach at St. John's University, Lou Carnesecca.
Of the Big East, and what a year they had. They almost had four in the Final Four.
And right in front of Lou, Dean the Dream Leminger, another former NIT most valuable player, superb playmaker for Al McGuire's Warriors of Marquette. Bradley by six, 50-44 as we resume. Both teams now have three timeouts left. We have 7:15 left in the game. Nice lead for Thurkill. David Thurkill is now 7 for 7, has 15 points.
Purdue surprised me going man for man, Scarce with four, Cross with four, and Bradley went right after. They isolated underneath with Scarce, and he just punched his ticket.
Ricky Hall called for the offensive foul.
All right, down court pressure. Willie Scott with the quick feet established his position. It was quick on quick, and Scott was quicker.
That's not bad. Do you write these out before the game, Buck?
No, man, I carry them on the top of my head, shoot from the hip.
Lyons hand check by Edmondson. Reese. Rebounded by Mine, so Bradley maintains possession.
A killer for Purdue. They forced two bad shots, couldn't get the rebound.
Oh, no harm, no foul, and now the whistle. And the call by Hank Nichols.
Followed by Ricky Hall.
That's Ricky Hall of Purdue.
It's one of
commits his second, and that puts the Boilermakers over the foul of it.
Right in front of the Bradley bench. A little body surfing there. Nobody can put a fork in it. Dick Versace a bit hot. He wanted it a long time before.
Barney Mines, 1-1. The foul shoot of 79%. Barney Mines played high school ball with a fellow by the name of Walter Downing, who is making a name at the DePaul. And it's Bradley by 10, 54-44. 6.5 left. Calabizio. And the foul. The basket counts, and Calabizio will go to the line.
Purdue wasn't pussyfooting that time. The down court pressure was attacked. Calabizio really not looking too smooth on this. Little half jump hook. The defense is still moving. A good call. A very unusual shot. One of the nice things about that shot is that his body continues toward the hoop, makes him an effective offensive rebounder. That time he didn't need it.
Thurkill committing his third. Calabizio, the freshman from Michigan City, Indiana, completing a three-point play. He now has 7. 54-47, Bradley by 7. 6:15 left. Willie Scott leading Anderson at a foul.
Willie Scott just blowing down the middle. He penetrates, but he's under control. Watch him veer off to avoid the charge. A good pass. Calabizio just hammers Anderson underneath. A pretty good foul.
Calabizio picking up his third. Here's Mitchell Anderson. Excellent big game player. Got off to the slow start here tonight and then came on. Run down the foul situation. Four apiece on Scarce and Cross. Reese and Cook with four apiece for Bradley. And Anderson misses both.
It was an especially good foul by Calabizio. That was just sure stuff.
And Anderson, a decent foul shooter, 74%. We are just under 6 minutes left. Scott going for the steal. Edmondson over Thurkill. He is really off. Calabizio going glass. Here's Scarce.
Oh!
And it's Purdue ball.
Nobody can pull that ball off the defensive board. Give credit to Purdue on that. They've got the bigger, stronger bodies, and they're hitting. Bradley, the quicker jumpers, just can't get control and run.
Stevenson.
Yes.
54-49, Purdue hanging in. Now by five, Edmondson, who has been off with only 9 points thus far.
Purdue again, strong man for man. They're going right across with four.
And the foul! Barney Mines will go to the line looking for a three-pointer.
Going underneath. Reese should have put that ball up. Ross isn't going to bother him. He kicks it out. Mines makes a great play under pressure. He's got a chance to make it a three-point play.
Foul by Edmondson. Timeout has been called. Greg Stewart of Tulsa, the MVP of last year's NIT, with Tulsa defeating Syracuse to win the championship. We'll be back with more basketball on Primetime Sports after these messages.
Last year, you found a part-time job, but after you graduated, it turned into a full-time chore. Mid-State College has a way out with programs that get you right into computer management, accounting, paralegal management, and court reporting. If you're still scraping by, give us a call and reach out for a better career. Call Mid-State College at 309-673-6365.
Peoria Savings is pleased to announce the first tax-exempt savings plan in U.S. history. It's a new federally approved and insured tax-free savings certificate. Maturity is 1 year and minimum deposit only $500. The exemption is up to $2,000 tax-free for a joint return, $1,000 for an individual. For current rates or to start your tax-free insured certificate, visit any Peoria Savings office, downtown Knoxville Executive Plaza and Wardcliffe Center.
By seven, with a chance to extend to eight. When they go to the foul line with 5 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the game.
Bradley has 25 wins. Only one other Bradley team did better. In 1960, a team that won this NIT had 27, and it was captained by Mike Owens, and a guy named Chet Walker was a pretty good player.
Here's Barney Mines looking to complete a three-point play. He's 2 out of 2 from the line, looking for his 13th point of the evening. It is Bradley, 57, and Purdue, 49.
Bradley coming back now out of the full court pressure, playing straight up man for man. This means we can look for it to go inside the cross, but we see Edmondson posting up. And it was Edmondson's man, third kill, who was in the lane. He's going to be
number three here.
Too many postmen in there that time for Purdue, because Cross was in very good shape, but because Edmondson went down inside, third kill, who's an exceptional athlete anyway, was two steps away and jammed it up. Purdue was fortunate that time to get away without a turnover.
Willie Scott picking up his third. Russell Cross, 3 out of 5 from the line. Dick Versailles chatting with Barney Mines. Both teams now over the foul limit. And Purdue trailing by 7, 57 to 50.
Last year we went overtime, Syracuse and Tulsa from the Missouri Valley. We could do it again.
It is Bradley by 6 as Scott races it down. Bradley has led by as many as 10. Purdue's biggest lead, a margin of 2, and that a brief lead. Scott, that's not a good shot. Willie Scott with a force from way out. And away from the ball, a blocking foul called on Bradley's Reese, and he is fouled out.
5-0 is like
this. Russell Cross was really barreling through there on a UCLA cut to post up. Reese took a heck of a shot. Dick Versace, fourth year at Bradley, not happy with that call.
And Donald Reese, a 6'9" senior, a three-year starter at center, is hearing it from the crowd as he, in effect, is bowing out of college basketball.
Well, this lead could shrink to four now. It appears that Bradley has lost its momentum a little bit. Certainly Willie Scott's shot with a six-point lead wasn't a good one, and he didn't look good letting it go either. I think he was hesitant.
Here's Russell Cross, one and one. So Cross has come on at the foul line after missing two of his first three. And it is now a five-point ball game. The Bradley lead is down to four. The foul committed by Donald Reese, putting Cross on the line. Lots of time left, 4.5 minutes remaining.
Remember now, Cross has four, Scarce has four. Bradley should be working on him.
This is Pines off the shake and bake move. Terry Cook, a bad shot again. And last touch by Purdue. We saw a poor shot heaved by Willie Scott a moment ago that led to the two free throws by Cross, and Terry Cook throwing a brick.
I keep looking for third kill to shape up inside with Scarce or for them to go right at Cross. Bradley's handling that ball. It's an adventure. They're not really sure if they're looking to score or whether they're holding it.
And this is obviously not their game. They like to run and gun, and now they're looking to slow it down with 3:35 remaining and involved in a four-point game with Purdue.
Got a case of stone hands developing out there. They need to get it in gear and flow. That's the only way they can play effectively.
Scarce up on third kill. Out of 3:15 left. This is Scott. Edmondson went for the steal. Here's Scott. That's a big bucket for the Braves of Bradley. They now lead it 59-53.
Well, that ball almost rimmed out. If Dick Versace had any hairs that weren't white, that was the end of that team.
Scarce with Bonavizio. This is Hall. Scott batted it away. Edmondson. And the foul called down low by Mickey Crowley. It is against Bradley. David Thurkill picks up number four. 1-1 upcoming for Keith Edmondson. Substitution now for Purdue. Jim Bullock, 6'6 freshman, getting sent to the front. And Bradley has called for time with 2:46 remaining in the second half, and Bradley leading Purdue by the score of 59-53. So Bradley now with one timeout left and Purdue with three. This championship game of the 45th annual National Invitation Tournament has been brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers. Reach for that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser for all you do. This Bud's for you. By GTE, a group of companies in telecommunications, electronics, lighting, and precision materials. By the U.S. Army, a place to be all you can be. By MasterCard, so worldly, so welcome, the only name you need beside your own. And by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world. And again tonight, a bang-up job done by our producer, Roy Hammerman, and director, Jack Simon. Bucky, you are average.
Hey, you got to encourage me, because when I grow up, I want to be just like you.
Buck, the walls are closing in on you. Too much New York exposure.
I tell you what, about this time in March, the balls do start to bounce a little harder. Interesting substitution by Purdue. Bullock, only a freshman in the game. He's in for Scarce. It's obviously a defensive ploy, because going back down, Purdue is going to have to get that ball back. I think we can look for Scarce to come right back in when Purdue gets it.
Edmondson 1-for-2 from the line tonight. He is a 79% foul shooter. 10 points for the senior out of San Antonio, Texas, who has had his hands full with David Thurkill. And it is Bradley by four, 59-55. Purdue coming off a one-point game against Georgia here. On Monday night, they pulled it off with 4 seconds remaining in the game.
Cross is now guarding Thurkill. If they can get the ball to Thurkill, Cross is in trouble. Thurkill too quick.
Eddie Matthews, a junior backcourt man, has come on for Bradley. Foul committed by Edmondson, his second. And so we will have a parade to the foul line in these final minutes. Here's Kerry Cook, number 52, returning. And Matthews will sit down. Mike Scarce is back. And Jim Bullock departs.
As we thought, an offensive defensive platooning situation going on at that position. Gene Cady, a tough coach, is described by Dick Precise, and his team reflects it.
Cross going high to snatch that missed foul shot by Thurkill. 2 minutes, 15 seconds remaining, second half. Purdue in possession and trailing by four. Calabizio forcing it to Cross, and the foul on Bradley. Foul committed by Kerry Cook, who has fouled out.
Edmondson wants it inside. Calabizio over the top, using his 6'7 to find Cross. I thought he might have shuffled his feet under there. They call Kerry Cook for the foul. Thurkill has basically taken Edmondson out of the game, but by doing so, it opens up the middle for Cross.
And Dick Versailles sending on Anthony Webster, 6'7" freshman from Cairo, Illinois. Kerry Cook fouls out, did not score. And here is Russell Cross, 7 for 9 from the line. Important free throws right here.
Fine shooting stroke for a big man. Good follow through.
Spent much time on the foul line against Texas A&M last Friday night. Anderson off the boards. Bradley by three. 59-56 as we approach 2 minutes remaining. This is Thurkill moving it back outside. Cross right with him. He's playing with four, as is Thurkill.
Bradley not really pulling it out. They're trying to run their regular offense, and they're not looking too good doing it.
And we get the call. 5 second violation.
5 seconds.
This is one of those difficult times where Purdue played great defense. They got the 5 second, and because of this new non-jump ball, it's their ball. That should not be a jump ball situation. Just like when you don't get over half court in 10 seconds, the ball goes to the defense. Likewise should it on that play.
However, the next alternate possession will go the other way to Purdue. And a reach in on Calabizio. So Anderson, who is 1 for 3 from the line, will shoot 1 and 1. Calabizio picking up number 4. Anderson, a 74% free throw shooter.
But 86 in NIT play, which is an impressive stat.
And Purdue has called for time. They now have 2 timeouts remaining. And Bradley has 1 left with 1:27 remaining in regulation. And Bradley clinging to a 3-point lead, 59-56. And we'd like to thank the following people for their help in the telecast of this year's NIT. Peter Carlissimo, the executive director of the MIBA, and his staff, the athletic directors, coaches, and sports information directors of the participating schools. Also, Lee Williams, executive director of the Basketball Hall of Fame, for providing much of the film footage used in our NIT All-Star Team features.
What a marvelous job they've done. Despite the expanding NCAA tournament, 6 years ago, Peter Carlissimo and the MIBA went to the regional sites playing the first round games on the campus. It was a shot in the arm, and instead of reducing the NIT, they expanded. and it has been a sensational tournament over these last 6 years. And these two teams are giving us a final, the same kind of a final that we've been used to. Good basketball.
The MIBA, the Metropolitan Intercollegiate Basketball Association, an affiliate of the Eastern College Athletic Conference, bringing you this 45th National Invitation Tournament. And we've come down to the final minutes. 1:27 left. This is Mitchell Anderson, 6'8" senior out of Chicago, who missed his last two free throws. He is 1 out of 3 from the line. His Bradley team up by 3. Bradley by 4, 60-56.
Missouri Valley with a great tradition. Remember, this man has been surpassed in scoring only by Oscar Robertson and Larry Bird in that league. That's big time.
Bradley by 5, 61-56. Edmondson with 1:20 remaining.
Bradley going zone.
Russell Cross. And the foul against Purdue. It's called on Dan Palavizio, so he is fouled out.
Bradley going 2-3 zone, but still Purdue finds Cross underneath. He gets an easy turnaround, and the foul is on the follow-up. Palavizio, a real hitter under there, a very physical player. He's going to be a good one in the Big Ten forward tradition, the Bruisers.
Mbolic replacing this man, Dan Palavizio. Here's it from the crowd. A solid game for Dan, leaving with 7 points. And again, here is Mitchell Anderson, who's now 3 out of 5 from the line. 1-1 for Anderson. Rebounded by Scarce. Again, a critical possession for the Boilermakers. Edmondson popping and continues to throw from all angles and has had his difficulties. As you see, time running down, and Anderson is crushed. So again, Anderson to the foul line.
You think he might be a little timid. He has not shot his free throws well, and he goes begging. Good move down the baseline. Look at the black jerseys. He almost had McGregor X10L stamped on his forehead. He was wearing 3 black shirts.
Edmondson picked up the foul. Mitchell, J.J. Anderson, 3 out of 6 from the line. It is Bradley by 6, 62-56.
He came off that ball awfully quick. There was almost no follow-through on that first one, and he was shooting it smooth early. Let's watch.
Scarce off the board.
He jerked it.
Here's Scarce, had it knocked away by Scott. Scarce. And a quickie timeout called by Purdue. They now trail by 4 with 42 seconds remaining in the second half. And both clubs down to 1 timeout remaining. With the score, Bradley 62, Purdue 58. Let's pause for these messages.
Bill Russell defined athletic artistry in the 1956 Olympics. And now he's been commissioned by Budweiser to create a painting to help raise funds for our Olympic team.
You get on the Budweiser Art Series and help our athletes train now for the gold in 84. And remember, the secret to fine art is ball control.
Call toll-free for more information on this art series from Budweiser, proud sponsor of the 1984 Olympic Games.
To minimize interference, satellite antennas are usually located in the middle of nowhere. After all, they are sending and receiving signals to and from satellites some 22,000 miles up in the sky. However, now there's a new kind of satellite antenna. It sends a more concentrated beam and cuts down interference as much as 90%. So this one can be located in the middle of anywhere.
Gee!
No, GTE.
A timeout apiece remaining for Purdue and Bradley. Bradley by 4, 62-58. And it is Bradley ball with 42 seconds remaining. Anderson inbounds. Third kill for Scott. Being chased by Hall and gets it across. As you see, down to 30 seconds remaining. And the foul as Mines was whacked by Bullock. Bullock was trying to knock the ball away and accidentally made contact with Barney Mines. Bullock over to apologize. And Mines, who is 3 out of 3 from the line, will shoot 1 and 1.
Mike Scarce, number 23.
Mike Scarce reporting back.
What about on the line? The shooter is Barney.
Greg Eifert, who was in briefly, sits back down. Gene Cady trying to prevent Scarce from fouling out, so he took about after that last timeout. Big foul shot for Barney Mines. 5-point Bradley lead. And here is Webster back, replacing Matthews, as both clubs are doing the shuffling here in these final minutes. Mines looking for point number 15. Bradley by 6, 64-58. Scarce letting it go. The clock does not start until he touched the ball. Here's Edmondson moving on to Webster. And rebounded by Webster. Scott fouled by Hall.
If Willie Scott cans these two, it's curtains. And in a way, it's sad. Certainly Bradley has played well. They deserve to win if they can hold on here and hit their free throws. Purdue has been here 3 of the last 4 years, and 4 years ago they lost a heartbreaker to Bobby Knight's Indiana Hoosiers, where it went down to the last shot.
Willie Scott, 8 field goals, 16 points. And what a tournament the junior out of Chicago, Illinois, Willie Scott, has had. He averaged 7.5 points a game during the season, but really breaking out of the NIT. 15 seconds left, Scarce. Webster for Scott. Time running down. The reverse by Mines to cap it off. 2 seconds, 1, it is all over. The Bradley Braves, the team snubbed by the NCAA, has won the 45th National Invitation Tournament. They have defeated the Boilermakers of Purdue by the score of 67-58. So Bradley has won the NIT for the fourth time in this, their 14th appearance in the tournament. And they finish with a record of 26-10. And there is the MVP of the tournament, Mitchell Anderson, who tonight hit 6 field goals, 4 from the line, for 16 points in all. So that's the end of the game. Final score, Bradley 67 and Purdue 58. We'll be back to chat with the most valuable player, Mitchell Anderson, right after these messages.
Hi, I'm Jack Sherman from Sherman's Place. We choose what we sell very carefully, and that's why we sell Zenith. Here's an example. This new video recorder from Zenith features some unbelievable special effects, and it's only 3 inches high. Or if you're looking for a new TV, we have some special Zenith factory buys. So for the lowest prices on TVs and video recorders, shop around. Then come to Sherman's Place for the best deal. We're located 3 blocks south of Sheridan Village behind the Apollo gas station.
Peoria Spring and Accessories offers you a lot more than just springs for your car. A galaxy of parts, sales and service you don't have to go out of this world to find. They've just landed the latest in electronic equipment designed to speed up service and excellence. Remember Peoria Spring and Accessories next time you need something for your car. If there's something we haven't mentioned, give us a call. I bet we have it. Peoria Spring and Accessories. A lot more than just springs for your car.
Coach Dick Forsythe, the 1982 National Invitation Championship. It wasn't the NCAA. Boston College wasn't here. You still have to feel good.
Yeah, I feel very good. I think this team vindicated quite conclusively what we were talking about before. That was not the crusade. That is not why we were here. We were here because the National Invitational Tournament is a very great tournament. It should always live forever. I want everybody in America to know that. And I also want them to know that the Missouri Valley Conference is a very tough basketball conference. And if you can be the champion of the Missouri Valley, you can be the champion of this country, and you should always have that opportunity.
All right, the most valuable player, Mitchell Anderson. For the second year, it goes to the Missouri Valley. You follow Greg Stewart, who last year from Tulsa won the award. What are your thoughts?
It's a great feeling. The Missouri Valley is a tough conference, and I think Tulsa proved it last year and Bradley proved this year. And we didn't get a bid to NCAA, but we won NIT, which is just as great.
All right, those free throws at the end. You had a little trouble early, but yet you seemed to be confident. You kept going to the basket, wanting to get fouled.
Well, I'm the leader on the team, and I felt it was my job. If anybody had to shoot the free throws, it should be me. Some came in and out, but I made a couple, and we won the game.
How tough was Purdue defensively?
It was pretty tough. Very physical, and they pushed us around a lot, but, you know, we all had a lot of poise, and we pulled it off.
All right. It was 31-31 at the half. What adjustments did you all make in the second half?
Well, we were going to try to get the ball inside and get Russell in foul trouble, which forced him to go to the bench, and we got a lead. And then our main concern was getting out and putting our break back on, and we did off and on, but, you know, we just had poise and hold on to the lead.
Had you seen a center as good as Russell Cross this year?
No. Russell is definitely an All-American.
All right. Thank you very much, JJ. Again, congratulations on the MVP.
Thank you.
Coach Forsythe, 31-31 at the half. You really hadn't gotten control of the tempo.
No, not at all. We got Donald Reese in foul trouble very early, caused us to play a substitute, hurts our running game, hurts us defensively. And so what I said to the guys at halftime, Bucky, was you shouldn't be discouraged because the subs, you did a great job of holding us in there. Now we can get our people back in and we'll win the thing.
All right. Hail to the champion of the Missouri Valley and the 1982 NIT. Marv Albert, we're back to you.
All right, Bucky, Purdue and Bradley battling it out here at Madison Square Garden. And Bradley has won the NIT for the fourth time of their existence, 67-58. The most valuable player, Mitchell Anderson, he scored 16 tonight. Willie Scott led Bradley with 17, 16 apiece for Mike Scarce and Russell Cross. Thanks to our statistician, Saul Weidler, our producer, Roy Hammerman, our director has been Jack Simon, Marv Albert, along with Bucky Waters, saying so long from Madison Square Garden in New York. This has been a presentation of Madison Square Garden Television through the facilities of the Hughes Television Network.
Bring United States Senator.
This special Bradley edition of Hilltop Highlights is being brought to you in part by Waterbed Warehouse, where the rest comes easy, and by First Place Trophies at 833 Northeast Glen Oak in Peoria.
Who are you for?
Bradley.
How many for?
About six.
Six?
That's right.
Jen Bierce wants to give you $750. That's right. Buy now and get $750 back on a high-mileage Fairmont Futura. Buy now and get $750 back on the family-sized Granada. Buy now and get $750 back on the sporty Mustang. Or buy now and get $750 back on Ford pickups and vans. Don't lose $750 by waiting too long. These rebates end soon. Hurry, get the biggest rebate and the best paid-in from the price leader, John Bierce Ford Subaru.
Lately, Bradley fans have probably noticed a new Dick Forsythe. At games and practices, I'm cool and calm. Part of the reason I feel is because of my waterbed from Waterbed Warehouse. I've never slept better, and I wake up refreshed and ready for another hard day. Stop by Waterbed Warehouse and let their professional sales staff explain all the benefits of flotation sleep. you'll feel great. I know I do. Now, if I can only get those refs sleeping on a waterbed.
Waterbed warehouse where the rest comes easy.
Okay, kids, take a
break. Coke is it the most refreshing way to make the most of every day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, there's something big waiting for me and you. Coke is it,
the biggest taste you've ever found.
Coke is it, the one that never lets you down. Coke is it, the most refreshing taste around. Coke is it, Coke is it.
Here you see a lawn tractor and a Kubota tractor. Here's the lawn tractor at work. Here's the Kubota tractor at work. Kubotas come with diesel engines, two- and four-wheel drive, and they handle many Kubota implements. So the real value in owning a Kubota is that it does what a lawn tractor can't do, as well as what a lawn tractor can do.
We're looking for work. Kubota, we're looking for work.
See the newest Kubota tractors at L.E. German Implement Company, Princeville.
Brandon University had the honor of playing in the very first game of the very first National Invitation Tournament. That was back on March the 9th, 1938. Braves lost to Temple University, 53-40. Carl Shunk leading Bradley with 18 points. Since then, the Braves have appeared in a total of 14 NITs, winning four of them. The first three coming under head coach Chuck Orsborn. Number one came in 1956-57. Shelly McMillan, Barney Cable, and Bobby Joe Mason leading the way. Mason had 22 points in the title game. Bradley beat Memphis State by 1 point. Title number two came in 1959-60. Chet Walker and Mac Herndon leading the way. Herndon had 26 points in the title game as the Braves ripped Providence 88-72. Title number three came in 1963-64. Joe Strutter, 29 points. Ernie Thompson, 21 points. And Laverne Tart had 20. As Bradley rolled past New Mexico with a lopsided score of 86-54. Tart was named the NIT Most Valuable Player. Well, it would be 18 years before Bradley would get another shot in an NIT title, and it came at a time when the Braves were thinking about going to a different tournament.
We beat St. Joe's in the Palestra. We beat Penn State at Penn State. We beat nationally ranked teams Tulsa and Wichita State. Now, if that's not enough to get you in the Final 48, then I don't have any control over what would get you in.
But Bradley rose to the occasion and swept aside American University, Syracuse, and Tulane in the 1982 NIT. Braves jumped out to a quick 13-1 lead over American and coasted to a 76-65 victory. This was win number 399 at Robertson Fieldhouse. Willie Scott got the road to New York off on the right foot with a career-high 19 points. This sent Bradley to Syracuse, New York, for game two. Bradley treated the Carrier Dome like the home court as the Braves beat the Orangemen 95-81. David Thurdkill and Mitchell Anderson leading the way with 23 and 20 points respectively. Bradley at one time during the game led Syracuse by 24 points. Braves won it 95-81, sending them back home for game three against Tulane. The Green Wave would be victim number 400 at the Fieldhouse. Braves took a 31-22 lead into the locker room at the half. It was all academic from there as Bradley won it 77-61.
How you guys feel right now?
Feels good.
Feels good.
On our way to New York.
On our way to New York, man.
Where you going, Donald? Where are you going? I can't hear you, man.
I said, where are you going?
To the Apple. The Big Apple. To take it all.
Take it all.
Start spreading the news.
The news.
I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues clouds are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York. In a city that never sleeps, and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hill, a number one. These little town up to you, New York, New York, New York.
At Valley Ford, we've got rebates and incentives going on all over the place. Right now, you receive a rebate of $275.
The first semifinal game at Madison Square Garden saw the Braves against Oklahoma. Bradley up by one at the half. They outscored the Sooners 27-9 at one stretch early in the second half, and it was all over. Willie Scott and David Thirdkill teaming up here for an easy two. Thirdkill follows that with a steal and two more points to make it 51-42. Another steal, this one by Willie Scott, and it was 61-46. The final again was 84-68. Sent the Braves into the title game with Purdue. Braves and Boilermakers played the first half even as it was tied 31-31 at the half. Great game for David Thirdkill. He hit 7 of 7 from the field and held the Big Ten scoring leader Keith Edmondson to just 11 points. Tournament MVP Mitchell Anderson dropped in 16 points for the Braves, including some crucial free throws down the stretch. Willie Scott, quarterbacking the Braves' fast break, tied for high point honors with Barney Mines, each with 17. Mines finishing the scoring with this reverse layup, and the Braves picked up NIT championship number 4 as they beat Purdue 67-58. Bradley Sr., David Thirdkill, third. What a way to go out.
What a great way to go out. There's only two teams that win the national tournament. And we won one of the teams, that's the NIT and the NCAA. And we didn't want the NIT. And I'm just happy. I'm happy. There's two teams that go out national champs, the NIT and the NCAA. And the NIT is over. Thank you.
Great, Donald. What a way to go out, buddy.
Yeah,
it was. You said you were going to do it.
Yeah, I had a feeling we were. I was, you know, I played hard, but they kind of, I thought they was going to take the game from us, but the guys pulled together when I fouled out, and they just hung in there, and we came out champions.
I'm standing between two very happy young men right now. On my left, Daryl Backstrom, who was Mitchell Anderson's high school basketball coach. Chicago Metro, of course, Mitchell Anderson on my right. I'll talk to Daryl first. Daryl, big thrill for you.
Hey, it's history. It's history. It's what he's been waiting for 4 years.
A lot of people don't realize you also coached Russell Cross for Purdue.
Hey, I had mixed feelings, but as far as this guy's concerned, he's number one on the list. He's hit parade.
He's done it all.
He's done it all.
Mitchell, congratulations. What a way for you to go out, young man. Tremendous game.
Thanks, Norm. What can I say? It's great. It's a great feeling. We done it.
You know, when you were snubbed by the NCAA, you just put your heads together. You said, hey, let's go all the way and win it. And this ball game really wasn't even close. You ended up winning it by 9. Tremendous effort.
Hey, we got here. We deserved it. The NCAA passed us up, and we won it. The Missouri Valley has won the NIT 2 years in a row.
Mitchell, just been named, I guess, the most valuable player. There he goes to accept his award. Mitchell Anderson, number 11, Bradley's all-time leading scorer. 67-58, Tony Barone, Rudy Keeling. Congratulations, Tony.
That was a great game. Kids played well. Did a nice job of in the second half of playing the pressure defense. I think that if Mitchell had been healthy all year, we could have played that kind of defense. We might not have lost 5 or 6 games.
Purdue makes a run. Both big guys sitting on the bench. You hang in there and you wind up winning by 9 points.
Yeah, I thought Kerry Cook did a nice job of going ahead and even though he was banging some people in there, he did a nice job of buying some times for our kids. So it was a good effort by everybody.
Rudy Keeling, nothing like winning this one in your own backyard, huh?
No, I love it. I love it. I love to come back to New York and show them what the Midwest can do.
You like the small guards, and Willie Scott has done everything for you.
That's right. I taught him everything he knows, and he's doing a great job.
I'll tell you what, Norm. Rudy has been a great addition to our basketball program as our academic advisor and assistant on the bench. He does a super job, and he's one of the reasons why these kids are playing today, really.
With me now is the only other Bradley basketball player ever to be named the most valuable player in the National Invitation Tournament. You older Bradley fans will recognize him. His name is Laverne Tart, who lives now here in Long Island, New York. Laverne, great game for you
fantastic
to watch.
Fantastic game. Great to see another MVP come from Bradley. This was nice.
You get a chance to follow Bradley at all living here in New York?
Oh, yes. I follow him every day. I watch the schedule every day and see what they're doing. I watch the playoff intensely very much. I was watching the scores. They winning very decisively all during the playoffs. So I was keeping close tack on them.
As a casual observer, what kind of ball club, how do you like the Bradley ball club?
I like them because they run. They play a running, fast break type game, which is what I'm accustomed to and which is what I like. They need a little more beef up front, but they'll get that. I'm looking for a couple of good big players myself to send to Bradley, so they're doing good.
Do you remember the thrill you got in 64?
Oh, it was fantastic. I'll never forget it. You know, we had half of Peoria out here. I think half of it came this time also, and it's great. It's a great feeling when you win. You know, you represent people all over the country, and everybody see you back home playing. It's a good feeling for the school and for the individuals who are involved.
Thanks, Laverne. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
That's former Bradley Brave Laverne Tart, 1964 most valuable player in the NIT. Barney Mines is running around here somewhere. We're going to bring him in now. What a tremendous, tremendous performance, not only all year from you, young man, but in the NIT. You just tore him up.
Well, it's a great tournament, and I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad we won it. You know, we had some tough battles Monday and today, and we came out ahead.
Barney, you guys snubbed by the NCAA. You come into the NIT. You're 5-0, of course, and champions. You win by 11, 15, 16, 16, and 9.
Well, hey, that just tells you something. You know, I think we should have been in the NCAA tournament, but we ended up in the NIT, and we beat every team by, you know, at least 10 points, 10 to 12 points. And
You came of age in this tournament, Barney. 18 the other night against Oklahoma. I don't know how many you had tonight. You had some clutch buckets, some clutch free throws. Tremendous pressure ball player. You like the pressure?
Yeah, I do. I like the pressure, and I like the big crowd, and especially this is my first time being in the Garden, you know, and I wanted to perform well, and I think I did.
What a way for the seniors to go out.
Oh, yes, it is. It's a great way, you know. And the halftime in the locker room, we told them, you know, this is the last go-around, you know, give it all you got. Give it 20 minutes, and they did. They came out and did it.
Think Bradley University will now get a little bit more recognition?
I surely hope so. I really do, and we deserve it, every bit of it.
Congratulations, Barney. We'll see you next year.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks much. Barney Mines, junior guard for the Bradley Braves. He'll be back next year, and we'll be back right after this. Bradley fans were very much involved in the Braves' victory.
About 1,500 of them traveled by bus, charter flights, commercial flights, and private planes just to be there to support their heroes. Much of the responsibility for getting the fans to and from New York on the charters was the job of Bradley business manager Ken Golden.
Organizing three different charters and several buses and hundreds of fans has to be, in my opinion, my greatest night for the university.
Well, they tell me, I heard Ron Ferguson up here say a while ago that the NIT committee told him this was the biggest group of fans they ever had here for an NIT game.
Well, I know personally, I saw over 1,000 tickets leave our counter right here, and many, many, many more were purchased right at the window. And of course, the NIT, they work on volume, and when we can purchase the most tickets of any other school, it's just unbelievable. And of course, then they'll keep their eye on us, and hopefully we'll be a big draw. And of course, we have hundreds and hundreds of alum from all over Jersey, New York, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Pennsylvania, that gather here tonight to celebrate.
One wonders just how much did the fans' support mean to the outcome of the game.
It's unbelievable. People here are shocked. They can't believe the, you know, the fan support that we've had, and it's amazing they all came out like they did. We're appreciative, certainly.
Rudy, are you aware, I mean, do you believe what went on at the lobby hotel before the game?
It was one of the most fantastic things that ever happened. All these people came out, some came out today just for the game, you know, it was super. And the fans from Peoria are the best you can have.
What about the fan support that showed up at the Garden?
I love it. I think we have at least close to 2,000-3,000 people out here. They're crazy. I love them all, though.
They're loyal followers, and they always have been. And if you could have been in the lobby of the hotel tonight, it was full of Bradley people, and they were cheering and praising the Braves and urging them on to victory. And I tell you, it's just great to be a part of this fine program.
We got some unbelievable fans. Peoria fans, my fans, people in New York, they all came out. Man, it's unbelievable.
Dick, I know, being the commissioner of the Valley, you cannot play favorites around the league. You've seen the fans from all over the league, but what can you say about the folks from Peoria?
They're awesome. That's all I can say. They're awesome. They're great fans. And, you know, during the season, Norm, we're unbiased, you know, we just sit there. But I had my chance to yell tonight, and I yelled. And as you can tell, I'm a little bit hoarse. And I also did it the other night, too, the first round game on Monday night.
Norm, it's been super. I can't thank our fans enough. God, I tell you, what a group. You should have seen the hotel. Yeah, you were there. They told me that we had the most fans from a school our size that ever come to the NIT in recent history. And boy, if that isn't a tribute to Peoria and to Bradley University and the support that they've had, that we've had, then I don't know what is.
I'm from Nebraska, and I follow Nebraska football, and I thought those people were really strong supporters, but I think the Bradley basketball fans are just unbelievable. And then today we bring in two more charters and all the people come in, and I just shook my head, you know, and I talked to people. You know, everybody's just going around kind of gaga. You know how that is?
As you can see, we're standing here with a group of Bradley students who made the trip all the way from Peoria to New York. And going quickly here, your reactions to the game today?
Well, I thought it was a super game. Bradley played well all the way, and I'm glad they won it.
How about you?
Great game. Great season.
You glad you came to New York?
Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Cost you a lot of money?
Yeah, we can travel cheap.
Excellent game. Excellent. One more time.
How about you, sir? Good top off to the season. We've been with them all the way, and we're just glad we were out here for this one.
Well, you actually sleep in line to get tickets to the game?
Two nights.
Only two nights.
The day when the NIT tickets went on for the Tulane game, we slept out that night.
We slept out two nights for our season tickets.
I think the university ought to do something for the Bradley students to where they don't have to sleep out at night.
Good idea. Better seats at the Civic Center. We're going to get them.
The party that followed at the Statler Hilton was one you almost had to see to believe. Wall-to-wall Bradley fans, most of them in red, all waiting for their heroes to enter the room. And when they did, the noise was deafening. After the party was over and things quieted down just a little bit, I finally cornered head coach Dick Versace.
The winning coach of the NIT tournament is provided with two airplane tickets from TWA to anywhere in the world.
Where are you going to go?
I don't know. I was thinking of Athens and a cave by the Mediterranean, and I'll send you a bottle of Greek wine.
I thought maybe I'd use the other ticket.
You ain't using it.
So, Coach, what do you got to say?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I've tried to tell you all year, we can beat anybody, any place, any time, and bring them all on, North Carolina, Virginia. We don't care. Bring them all on.
In Peoria, right?
And, no, any place. I don't care what we play.
How about the Superdome?
Hey, I don't care. Bring them on.
Peoria?
Gavin can even sit on the bench with us. I don't care where he sits.
I'd like for all you Bradley fans now to meet one of the hardest working young men I've known for the last 4 years at Bradley. His name is Paul McCree. He's the Bradley manager. And Paul, your thoughts right now after winning the National Invitation Tournament Championship?
Well, no, you can't top this. I've been with Coach Assays for 4 years. I'm one of only five that's been with him. And we've been through the ups and the downs, the trials and tribulations, the thrill of victory, the agony of defeat. We've been through it all, and this is the highlight of it all.
The Braves returned home on Thursday to a wild celebration at the airport and at the university. Les Shapiro was there.
When the Braves and their entourage arrived home at about 3 p.m., the fans weren't the only ones at Peoria Airport to greet them. So was Illinois Governor James Thompson. He and the team rode home from the airport in a slow motorcade back to the school, where at least 2,000 screaming people cheered Bradley's victory.
Who's the number one best basketball team in America?
Has been a presentation.